7-Eleven.
Do you have an agenda card?
Yeah, it was just 2018 budget and teen camp.
Okay.
So we can talk about teen camp if you guys wanna introduce that, that would be great.
Well, I put this together so the select board would have something to look at. At the bottom is the actual schedule, Mondays, Tuesdays, Wednesdays off, Thursdays, and Fridays. Fridays, these are just ideas, throwing it out there. Friday, they would go to the pool, every Monday they would go to Water Country. I talked to Water Country, and if we bought season passes for everybody, they could go, it would be their own season pass, as long as they have it with them. I said, you don't mind a bus showing up of season pass holders? And they're like, no. I'm like, okay. So if we went every Monday, that'd be fine? She was like, sure. I'm like, okay. And there's actually discounts for Black Friday and for Christmas, but the budget wouldn't pass until March, so for this year that wouldn't work, but for the following year, we could get it at a cheaper rate at $65 per person. I limited it to 40 campers, and then getting a season pass like you guys did last year to hit all the hiking points, and then a couple of like kayaking trips, Blitz Air Park, the Fun Center, Splash Town. It's all, if you go to the first row, the Water Country Pass would be $65 a kid. 8 weeks of the pool would be $21.
Read 7 though, right, Joey? So, because it's a 7-week program. So you did.
I kept playing with a 6-week to 7-week program and seeing how it would fit into the budget.
But you did the math, because the pool is $3. So
yeah, I did the pool for, I did everything for an 8-week program, then I shortened it to a 7-week program, but the money was just too high. I was trying to keep the cost.
Right. I got so the 21 would be the 7 weeks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What are you charging for the campers today?
$120 for.
Oh.
Right down here.
Yeah, $120 for in town, out of town, I said $140. So I asked as many parents as I could if that was a good price, and they said for what they were doing, absolutely. So a kayaking trip was $65. They would get 4 shirts, that's included in their fee, it's $20. Because they have to wear it at all times because they have to be differentiated if they're going to be at the same built place where the little kids are, we're going to have to differentiate. As we found out last year, counselors and kids this age are all the same size. So that was the $7 is their portion of the bus pass. I allocated the price of the buses. A trip to Blitz Air Park is $20, a movie for $10. In case one of these is a rained out day, you can just go to the movies kind of thing.
So was that the bus pass was the $7 for the 1 week? Is that what you're saying? Was the whole cost of their bus transport?
That's their portion, divided it up by 7 weeks.
Okay.
So
that seemed low to me, so that's why I was like.
So their portion of the bus transportation is $153 for the summer.
Okay.
That's 4 trips a week at $250 a bus trip. So that would be one camper's portion of their, so that's how I came up with that. Staffing, 3 staffers, and a director, and then estimated taxes.
So when they're not at the pool or at Blitz, where are they?
If they're not at the pool or at Blitz, they would start late or something like that. I don't expect them to be there at 8 o'clock in the morning. They're going to. That's something the select board would have to decide on if they can show up on their own and, you know.
Well, no, I was just trying to figure out if we were picturing this being they arrive right when the buses leave.
They can.
Okay, or they can come, so where would they be? Are they going to be at the same place as the younger kids?
They would be at the same place as the younger kids if they show up at 8 o'clock in the morning.
But there would be 2 totally separate camps being
there. Completely, yeah. Different counselors, different staff. Different color shirts, so
would
you differentiate.
But with like the idea of the pool trip going all together though with the little ones as well, yeah.
Yeah. Oh yeah. they definitely have to have a different color shirt, because, you know, a 9-year-old's gonna be like, hey, I wanna go to Water Country today and sneak on the bus. So I tried to think of everything and just give it one lump sum instead of collecting $5 here and $5 there and $5 here and $5 there, and which apparently drove our accountant nuts anyway, so.
So they would not be there for pizza day, so that would not affect our pizza totals and stuff like that. That was Wednesday.
We can change days. This was just a brainstorm.
But they would still
be. And you can allocate other things to do or whatever. And I took the list of what the kids wrote down for me one day. I happened to be there one day and two kids were sitting around doing nothing. I'm like, make me a list of what you'd want to do. And a lot of it was with the fun center, with their park. And then I asked around and I asked that age group. I said, would you mind if you went to Water Country once a week? Would you be bored? And they're like, no. So I asked around. I asked that age group because I'm thinking, okay, we're going to Water Country every single week. And they were thrilled with it. Like, all the kids I asked were like, absolutely. And even the older kids, like 16, 17, 18-year-olds I asked. And they were like, no, that'd be awesome. So I tried to get as much feedback as I could.
And then the other idea that we talked about was that this would not be an all-inclusive. So that if you wanted to sign up for 3 of the 7, you would have that option.
What is the weekly? What would be the weekly charge?
So that would be the 118.
$118
for Rollinsford kids, or the
total would be 8.
Yeah. So that there would be an option of. The only other thing I guess we'd have to think about is if you wanted to pay for the whole summer up front, what you would there be any type of discount for?
Sure, it's $850 or $825 if you pay ahead.
There you go.
I talked to my kids about this yesterday or today, and I said, hey, how would you guys feel about this schedule? And one of them said, that's too many trips.
Okay.
But, so I said, okay, but what if you didn't go every week, right? So that would be the option. You can go this week, but not the next week. And then, so she's like, oh, yeah, okay. Yeah. So.
And Dorothy and I also had a conversation about this on the phone when she was preparing it. And UNH runs a camp during the summer. 1 week is 2 field trips. You're at UNH. The following week is a field trip every day. And so it's 5 field trips the second week. And theirs runs like $250 for the week that you're on campus and $300 for the week that you're off campus all week. So, but they're going to like the Museum of Science and like, I think Legoland was in there one day and something like that. So they're doing trips to Boston and Mass and all over the place. So compared to some of the other programs in the area, it is a cost savings per week.
That's 2 questions. That would be, are they going to be able to arrive on their own?
Oh.
And would they be able to leave on their own, which is for the select board to decide. I have to ask them tomorrow. Mm-hmm. And then it's up to us, because we're already going to be there at 8. So mm-hmm. They can be there as early as 8. I'm thinking either way is fine with me at this age, at the older age. Because when Zoe and Zach are 15, I'm still not going to be able to. I still have to drop them off at 8. I still have to be at work at 8. So.
But a lot of people in that situation just leave their kids at home.
Right, but how do they get put to the camp then?
Right. They'd have to ride their bike or be picked up by somebody else.
Right. Because not everybody lives
or
in
walk.
Stockdale.
Right.
So,
right.
Like my.
Well, I don't live in Stockdale, but my kids still walk there.
Well, ours have to navigate Route 4, so that's a little bit harder. In Oak Street, with no sidewalk. Yeah.
So, what were the hours that you put in for this 35 hours a week for the staff?
Yes.
So, we could stagger that if we needed to.
I think it's a fantastic idea. I think the pick a week is also great. I think maybe we'd bump it up. If it's a pick a week, though, because you're gonna have some weeks where you have 35 and some weeks that you have 40. You still gotta pay your employees.
Yes.
So I think maybe we could brainstorm that instead of just dividing it by whatever you did here, 7. You know, maybe it's 150 if you wanna pay weekly. And I know my kid would love it, but he'd probably only do 2 or 3.
Yep.
Like your kid said, Water Country every Monday? They've gone 7 weeks in a row, Dad. You know? Well, poor you.
Yeah.
You know? but I think that's fantastic. The only thing I would say is I think we should bump that up because we're going to, you know, but again, this is just a brainstorming thing.
Yeah.
I think it's great.
Yeah. I had to throw a number at the board, so.
Yep.
This is what we came up with. So if you did less trips, if it was only twice a week or whatever, we can work it from here, but.
And if somehow, we had talked also about somehow having more, and I don't know how that would work with kids, but more part-time employees, and if we don't need you these 2 days, or we don't need you this week, you know, is that possible to say, I don't know.
I think that's hard with Hannaford's playing 12:50 guaranteed 30 hours.
Yeah. Yeah, we had like Kara, your niece there.
Yeah.
Yeah,
so I don't know if that you know, to kind of reach out and find as many people like that that we can. Well, if you don't care about working a full week.
I bet a lot of kids who are 16, 17 years old might not. I mean,
But then the issue is, are you going to have 16-year-olds watching 15-year-olds? They might be watching their boyfriend or girlfriend. I don't think that's going to work.
You can't date the camper.
Yeah.
13?
I think he said
12
to
15.
Yeah.
Okay. So then if you have a 16-year-old, which is part of, I think, why you probably have 15 there, because you want an 18 or 19-year-old.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. That would be a part-timer.
Well, maybe you could have a part-timer doing the younger kids, and then these counselors could float back and forth when they need it. They have one or two that would float between the two programs.
Yeah. And this camp ends August 7th. So it attracts more, I'm hoping to attract more of the college-age kids to be counselors. So,
yes.
It won't interfere with them going to a community.
And what we had all discussed was taking advantage of that UNH thing again that we just need to get on top of that, like early this year. We can get half of our K-4. That would be great.
Mm-hmm.
And they would be older, maybe in college.
Now, I know we had talked a while back about just instead of all of these trips, maybe like some sports related stuff, like taking them to the tennis courts either in South Berwick or to at the across from the fire department or at Berwick Academy. Could that be an option? And then it wouldn't, like, I don't know.
Instead of like maybe one of the
stagger the Water Countries, maybe like do it every other week.
Well, I even talked too about if you look at this, our swim day, right? So we only go to the pool at 12:15 or something. It's like, well, you know, what about that morning you have their exercise, whatever, time, and then they're all sweaty to go to the pool. So I don't know. Do we have something to do that would be like a volleyball morning or something that we could do that at camp at Raleigh?
Yeah, I don't know how much did the volleyball net use last year?
Not very much.
Used a lot by me and my son after hours.
Because yeah, I mean, you could get some older kids to do like a little volleyball tournament in the morning and then go swimming after.
Yeah, nice for that to use a little bit more.
Yeah.
I have heard a question. Is there a chance that, and this may need to go to the select board, Jody, transportation-wise, could the teen camp, could a couple of parents or a couple of volunteers put them in 15-passenger vans in front of them?
I called the insurance company. I tried to get them an air-conditioned bus through Feliciano, and our insurance company said that you better make sure that they have so much coverage and blah, blah, blah. And they have to be, it was like $1 million per incident and $300,000 per student. And Feliciano does have that type of insurance, but it also came with a $450 price tag per day instead of a $250 price tag per day. So, but no, we're not allowed to bus around our kids. Summer camp program with our insurance company would not allow it unless they were insured. So I don't know if anybody that keeps that type of insurance on them do.
And then you also need not just personal insurance, yes,
yeah,
but commercial insurance.
Yeah. Primates even was like even questioning Feliciano. I was like, but they're a limousine company. I'm like, they're a bus company. That's what they do. He's like, So I was like, okay.
Now these are older kids. Could they, you say like, that first week hike Mount Major. What about like hiking through the scallions and stuff like that? Is there a stay back option for them to do something like that, or is it all or nothing?
It's an all or nothing. Yeah, you're only talking for at the most 40 campers, and they can rearrange this as they when the counselor's hired, they can rearrange it. It's just an idea of how to fund it. Was to do with it. I just had to put down something for numbers and something for days. And what can I do to occupy their time with? And yeah, they could help hike Scotland or that walk you guys just did today. You know.
Yeah, because the historical committee decided what we got out there, that we definitely need some help cleaning up the trails on the other side of the Pony Bridge. Get those prickers out of there.
Because that's a class 6 road. Right.
Well,
that road right across from Selma.
Yeah, we went down Dodge Farm Road, and then we cut through the ATV trails to get to the Pony Bridge, and from there we went down past the Pony Bridge to where the river comes in, and we were going to go across the river to the old pest house. When we got to the river, we decided it was a little too dangerous to get across with the leaves and the wobbly rocks and logs down there. So most of us decided to come back. About a half dozen people went across.
But they did go.
Yep.
Yeah.
Anybody
fallen? I saw one person lose their balance, but I had two screaming kids, so I went back. My husband ended up being there an extra half an hour to 45 minutes, ensuring that everybody got back.
So I guess overall, we all like it. Obviously, it's a work in progress.
It's fully funded, so we should be good.
Yeah,
for
that. It was fully funded. It was revenue neutral with the actual budget was $35,000.
So what did it say about?
They haven't even looked at it.
Okay.
Well, I sent it to them, and I think it got cabled last week or the week before or whatever. It was cabled, right? They're like, we'll look at it later. Yeah, we didn't discuss it in detail yet.
Okay, so it's
because the committee hadn't met, they decided to table it, but we hadn't met.
Yeah. So understanding this is something that you just brought to the table, will this be... I know you said it's going to be separate from the summer camp,
mm-hmm.
So is there going to be... A new campaign of sorts, I guess?
Yeah, I asked Kristen to create something. I pretty much gave a free reading. I said, name it whatever you want. Give it a color t-shirt. Just has to be different than Camp Raleigh and, something a teenager would wear.
Yeah, I talked to her a little bit about it. She happened to be at that tour, that trail.
Yeah, I think they gave her until like January 1st or something.
Yeah.
Or would you call it?
Who's
know.
Clever here?
Dan.
Teen Raleigh, Camp Raleigh.
Teen Raleigh, is that what you said?
Send it to her. But she was more than happy to put something together for us.
Is that great?
Yeah, I like it.
Check that box.
I mean, I'm in that, you know, I'm the anomaly here with my five children, so, you know, expenses for me are, that's that, and plus my three other ones, like, so I could do this a couple weeks, but I couldn't do it like the whole time. So that's good, options are good.
Can we make a motion that if you're on the committee, you get it for free?
Absolutely.
Would you like to make that motion? And Kelly says,
I second it.
Because of the innocence.
Free at team camp or free at camp? Oh, at camp.
Kelly moves to amend the pet to all camps.
That would be where you do have multiple children, you know? You know, if you have your four or more children, if they, the cheaper camp is free or something to that effect. So.
Do we need to take a vote on it since we got a motion and a second?
I'm in.
I didn't love you guys.
Oh,
I thought that was a sarcastic.
Okay, I make a motion that if you have four or more children going to camp, then the fourth, fifth, et cetera children would be 50% off the lower priced camp.
Well, I guess I have a question.
I had to think about it.
I'll second that.
Okay.
How many families did we have that had four, five, or six?
One.
One?
You're looking at it. I think there was maybe two or three that I know of.
But maybe that might be something holding back other big families. Like, didn't we have a family that had, like, six that... I don't know if they ever made it to camp or not.
The only concern there is, since we ended the last one in the red, are we going to increase everyone's costs to shoulder that burden?
Good question.
Because now we know we're looking at potentially giving, based on what you said, I'm saying in my head, four campers 50% off.
Mm-hmm.
So that's two free campers. So just using easy numbers, that's $500.
Mm-hmm.
So if we had 100 campers, so that means are we going to up the cost by $5 to everyone?
That's a good question. So.
What was the repeat? What did you said?
I was thinking about what you said.
It was the Anderson class.
It was really good.
Jody made a motion to say families with four
or
more get an additional, four or more. Get additional members of the family at a 50% lesser price, for the lesser price.
Starting with child number four.
Lesser camp tuition.
Lesser price.
Right. So it would start with child four.
Child four. So it would be one, two, three. Like at the words, your second child is going to come. So if I were to bring Zoe and Zach there, I'd make the price for Zoe and 20% off for that. Surprised I
don't
charge me 20%
more, but whatever.
But
didn't we do three or more
for the summer camp? Well, I mean, there's a couple of tiers. You could just do 10% off the first, 20% off the second, 30% off the third, 40% off the fourth.
That would be a nightmare for registration, though.
I'll keep track of all those.
I think registration this year. What did we do that? We did do that, except I didn't have. It was one. It was up to three. Was the same
right.
Price, right? So we did do that this past year. Because it was the same rate for one through three.
So I'm fine with the idea, I just, nothing's free in this world, so that means we just have to bump up tuition for everyone else to compensate for what we're figuring to be $500 that we're gonna get less. If we did that.
Well, it would be on the Camp Raleigh, not on the summer.
Yeah, yeah.
So, I forgot what we charge for Camp Raleigh. It's like two, well, it's $240 for one, it was $440, that's without the registration fee.
It was $240 for the whole summer.
Yes.
So if you bump that to $250, then?
Well, I think we had talked on that, and we can go there if we want to, but about bumping up tuition a little bit for next summer. $55. Can you do that, Dean, in your, in the new?
Just to give your.
3%?
So, yeah, I'm a little bit behind, so I'm catching up, sorry.
So, we actually had a discount for large families last summer.
What was the discount?
So it was 1 through 3, so the final payment was 600 and something, 600 and.
So for 1, 2, and 3 children, you pay $240 for the first, and then.
Yeah. And then it was less, it's less for the second. So it was, so how it worked out was, let me write it down. So it was $30 a week for the first kid.
Mm-hmm.
And then it went down 25 for the week for the second kid. And then it was 20 a week for the third kid. So whatever that was. So we did offer a discount last year.
Okay.
And then it maxed out at that.
So then.
Well, no, it was for more than three.
So I added it all in together. So when we did the numbers, so it was $440.
Yeah, $440 for two.
Yeah.
And $600 for three.
Right.
So
yeah.
Three.
Plus
yeah,
was
more.
The same.
So.
Yeah.
I'd say just leave that always then, but we can bump that
right. up. So the only difference
do,
now would be
slightly.
That you have more, so you have some in the teen, which really.
I have one baby that has 5 and another one that has 8.
Oh, that's right.
8.
Ooh.
So.
There's somebody on Stockton that has 8 kids.
Mm.
Wow.
Mm.
I did not
so
know.
So how about your 8th kid?
I can be free.
If you can call your own softball team, you're free.
Usually those kids are also so spread out that you're not ever going to have that many in the camp at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
Her kids range in age, from what I understand, from 15 to a year or so.
Yeah. Well, it's no, newborn.
Yeah, newborn.
Oh, I think you're doing that. Yeah, and even at 118 for a teen camp, I'm afraid we're still not going to capture the kids we need to capture. Do you think it's too much?
Do you think?
But there's no way not to be too much.
Well,
so.
that would be. If we sliced one of the trips off and have it a 3-day a week, then you can drop costs to make it less. If you could do this for a teen camp under $100
yeah.
a week,
yeah.
that would probably
increase the
right.
Actually, that's not a bad idea if you did Monday, Wednesday, Friday.
Mm-hmm.
So,
and then, you know, I was kind of looking at all your.
Aren't going to want their 12-year-old home alone.
What were they doing with them
last year?
Before.
Yeah, I think a lot of them left their 12-year-olds home last year.
I'm not there yet.
Well, maybe make this because what was it 12 to 15?
I'd love
you
to
this
stay home.
Idea?
Yeah.
Maybe make it 13.
But you know what? So Shelby was 12 last year. She was bored. She didn't want to come.
Yeah.
After she was bored, so she needed something like
kids
this.
Kids who just left RGS.
Yes, right. So those sixth graders that are moving into seventh grade were just, I think they were just, it was too young for them.
Yeah, definitely deserve that.
Yeah.
All the trips.
So those would be our 12-year-olds that are going into seventh grade. So I think this would be great for them, and the parents that didn't sign up their kids for Camp Early that had that age group, they're, most of them work, I know that they're all, they were home, you know?
And I did have one or two parents who ordered t-shirts for their kids, say, asked me if there was something for our older kids.
Okay.
So, I do know at least one family.
So maybe if we combine, like, Jody, I love all these ideas, maybe if we combine, if you guys look on the Tuesday, Thursday, you know, maybe we can kind of pick the things in there and combine them, like,
yeah,
and have that the third day.
Obviously keep the bus pass, obviously
yeah.
Keep Water Country.
Yeah.
Because it comes with, they'll have a season pass for this.
Yeah, that's awesome. I think that's awesome.
Like, it's their pass. They can go 5 days a week if they want.
Yeah.
But then, some Monday right here, Torch and Town Four and Water Country.
But that's where your movie.
That's where the movie comes in.
It's like, okay, it's raining
today. Or even Blitz Air Park.
Yeah, right.
Right?
Substitute.
It's for the state park.
The state park.
Oh. So they'll, all of the campers would go to the state park.
I mean, the only issue is what happens if Johnny forgets his pass that day?
He doesn't get to go.
And he's been dropped off by mom, and he has to cross Route 4 to get home.
Right.
And
mom doesn't come bring him the bus pass and right outside Water Country.
But mom works in Boston, and she's not.
But mom's coming back to get Johnny, because he's going to stay with the Camp Raleigh kids until mommy comes back.
I guess that's our fallback. Okay, now you have to stay with Camp Raleigh. And oh, by the way, they're colored.
Now you're selling popsicles. Now you're selling popsicles for me today.
Right, right. Yeah, no,
okay, as long as there's some kind.
Take them on as a volunteer counselor.
Yeah.
Oh. As long as there's, because I can see every, there's going to be one kid every trip that, oh.
That's just the nature of kids.
Yeah.
Teenagers. And there's always
going to be or your passes. If your parents want you, want us to hold your pass. Well,
that just means you can't use it on your own over the week, right?
Yeah, as they get on the bus, you have to take their pass from them to make sure that they have it.
Right.
And you, yeah, okay. All right. So I think it's a good idea. I think so now.
So maybe what we're talking about, right, is maybe reducing the rate to under 100.
Okay.
Trying to, and maybe making that a 3-day. What do you think, Dan?
I think 3 days.
Three-day. Yeah, that'll save a ton on,
because
it's the bus transportation that kills us.
Right. 3-day. And then, yeah, I love all these in here. Like, when I told my kids, you know, like, ooh, like Mount Major. And they're like, ooh, kayaking? Yeah, so they were definitely.
No,
yeah,
the kayaking.
Was
the kayaking?
Oh,
kayaking.
So kayaking was right in Rye. They would put the water, the kayaks right in Rye Harbor. I forget the actual name of the company. But I'm like, give me your slowest day of the week, and we'd be there on that day. And they love the idea. They're like, great, yeah, awesome.
Do we need extra counselors for Camp Raleigh on days where we had trips, or no?
As the year progressed, the summer progressed, I mean,
okay.
Kids, they just weren't the numbers anymore. Mm-hmm. Like,
the first couple
only
weeks
kids would
great.
Show up, you know.
Yeah, the first 2 weeks
so we
were
had more.
Staffed. Cool. So where do we stand on the proposal of 50% off the
no one said yay or nay. We were in discussion.
Okay.
I don't think coming from like the only person really that might be you know, I think having the option to choose weeks is good because that allows me to be financially, you know, responsible
yeah,
for that.
Like the 4th of July weekend
right.
Or whatever.
Or I go on vacation
right.
In August
right.
And so, yeah. It's all
I want to be flexible.
Yeah,
but I think you would have to sign up for your weeks before the camp starts.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Just so we could plan.
Yes.
My problem is, do you say, okay, we're going camping on week, or kayaking on week one, and everybody signs up for week one, and no one signs up for week two? And
that's the risk.
Do they know what's coming ahead of time, or is just that the week you're signing up for?
No, I think we gotta tell them.
No, because I mean, kids would go, I don't want to kayak, I don't like to kayak, and now they're stuck doing it, versus other kids would be like, oh, I want to make sure I get on that week.
Okay.
Yeah, I think we tell them the schedule.
And then that might allow us to do our, you know, our counselors in place, right?
Yeah.
I mean, like, okay, we only need, you know, two for this week, or because we only have 25 kids that week.
So you'll charge them a full week even if they know if they don't like to kayak and wouldn't be there.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
So
yeah.
Yeah. Then you either sign up for the week or you don't.
Yeah.
How many counselors looking to hire for?
Three counselors and a director, so it'd be a 10-to-1 ratio.
It'd be a different director for this camp versus St. Charlotte.
Yeah, I actually have a teacher in mind. She is the drama teacher at my kid's school, and she took the entire department to New York City for the weekend, so I thought she could handle part of country. So I don't know what she has planned for the summer, but I was going to reach out to her. I figure she can handle New York City, she can handle water country.
So I get the water country idea.
The country does.
It's summertime, but I can tell you right now, I wouldn't send my kids to the water country.
Yeah, I mean that.
Oh, how come?
How do I say this? There's perverts that sit there and take photos of the kids.
Yeah, I just read an article.
So they've
charged that water country.
And there's another guy that sits there and takes photos and the cops know, but they can't do anything because he then changed the heads and puts a different head on the photo. And so we don't send our kids there.
So
do
we not send them to Splashdown either?
He gets a pass, he sits there, and he can't do anything about it. Huh?
So do we not send them to like Splashdown either? Or
well, I just know that's my concern with that place.
I got a -5 for water country too. We went to Funtown Splash in the summer and I thought it was great, you know. But who knows if they
have
their own problems, you know.
Yeah.
I mean water country is just, I mean, it's just so close to the Mass border, it's just, you know, not for Massachusetts people on the bus, but there's so many people that come up to that park. It's every time I've ever been, it's just a madhouse, you know.
I mean, I'd rather do personally a beach versus water country. I would send my kids. If it was a beach, but water country, I'd be like, nope.
Okay.
Just for that reason.
So like Hampton Beach and Ellis Sands and...
I think Short Sands is great because it's small, it's kind of in a...
Wallace Sands.
Wallace
Sands is a great beach.
I didn't put York on there at all. If you show up with a bus, are you charging? You're not charging.
York Beach is not included in our state park pass.
Right.
But Hampton is, and one of the beaches at Hampton is. And
but
so
if you show up in a bus in York Beach, how does that work? I don't see any buses at York Beach.
It's really no good parking, is there? I mean, it's
yeah.
all on the road, isn't it?
Well, at Short Sands, you can kind of,
there's
a parking lot that you could kind of, I don't know where the bus
would. Why can't the bus drop them off and go
and
drive to Hannaford 3 miles away and wait for 4 hours and then
yeah.
come get the kids?
Right.
Yeah, no, I was just thinking of, like, going through the gate kind of thing. Like,
there's no gate?
There's no gate.
No.
They only charge at Short Sands when I bring my family is the quarters in the machine.
Right. Yeah, the same thing at Long Sands.
Yeah, Long Sands, the same thing.
So when you have to, it doesn't even matter then, right? You just go right up the bus.
Right. You can go anywhere.
You pull up, drop off, they get out, say, be back here in 4 hours. So the only cost is the bus.
If we wanted to go to any of the beaches on Jenis State Beach is a part of the...
And Jenis State Beach, I was just thinking of that one in my head. I go there with the phone with my kids. They don't have a gate either. You just pull in and park, and you pay for your parking at that. No, is it Jenis? The one of them. Maybe Wallace Sands, I think.
Wallace Sands has a gate.
So then it's Jenis Beach, and Jenis is right across the street from a hotel. So the bus could park across the street, and there's a convenience store right there, and then there's bathrooms there, and you can walk right on the beach.
Other hikes too. I mean,
absolutely. I like the hike. I like the
major hike.
Mount Chicora is not that far, it's much more intense of a hike.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's real quick, that's like a...
That's quick.
Yeah.
So, but the overall, and I think we like this, we don't have to figure out the trips and everything exactly, but I think let's move forward with it.
Yeah.
Well, if we don't want Water Country in there, that drops a fee, a big, that's a big fee.
That's, and I mean, I could be completely out...
For everyone, but...
Yeah, I mean, I'm just saying, if I paid for that week, that's one of the days I would not...
I'd be very unwilling to send my 12-year-old daughter unaccompanied to Water Country, just, I don't know, I just, I wouldn't do it.
What gets me about water parks is, I always get concerned about what's floating in the water, what bacteria is there. That's what gets me.
You can say that at the pool.
Yeah,
it's the same.
But I know at, like, the pools I've been to, the Y, the Works and stuff, they'll pull you out the moment they suspect something. My kids just had swimming lessons at the Works, and a kid with hearing aids lost his hearing aid, and they thought it was a poop, and they got all of us out and told us we weren't allowed back in for half an hour to 45 minutes because they were shocking the pool.
Mm-hmm.
And then they discovered that this kid was missing his hearing aid, and they went around and said it was a false alarm. 15 minutes later, they had a caution tape all the way around their pool. So at least I know who those kid queens.
Well, they're supposed to do that in Water Country, too.
Lazy river.
You can get day passes at the Works, right?
That
yes, you can.
Yep.
Yeah, I think they're like
that's
$10.
Cool.
$10.
That would be, I think, a really good idea because then I could afford various things.
So along with the other hikes of Mount Aggie and Mount Chicora, I put in the Scout Lands and the Dog Farm.
Sure.
Yeah. It's also just real quick. Like they had a bunch of kids. I mean, I've hiked with teenage kids before, and it's like they move. You know.
I'll take them down the Dodge Farm. We were 2 hours.
Oh, really?
In, and like, to get in and back was 2 hours, and we didn't even go the whole way.
Just
oh, I never thought of that.
The Scotland is not too... It's great.
It's a quite a big run.
Oh, yeah. I tried it in Washington with the students before, and I was like, I was like the leader of the first group, and I lasted about an hour. Like, I can't physically can't have a heart attack. They just want to go.
We also have to be careful if it's a 90-degree day or whatever.
Mm.
We might lose a couple kids.
Yeah. Movie day.
So how do we move forward, or where are we at?
Just that, are you okay with this $35,000 presentation to the budget?
I think if we do it, cut it to 3 days, it might end up coming back a little bit.
So do we want that, those numbers, if we do a 3-day?
Do we want to present to the select board $35,000?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Someone like to make a motion?
I'll make a motion to present this $35,000 budget to the select board and implement it at a later date. Or just present it?
No, you're just presenting?
To the school.
To the select board. The select board hands it over to the budget committee. The budget committee will decide on what they want to do with it, then it goes to town meeting.
I second that.
Okay.
This just allocates us to expend and raise $35,000. And at the moment, it's revenue neutral, so no matter if we change it to 6 weeks or 5 weeks or 4 days or 3 days, we're still going to create a budget within $35,000. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Any nays?
You passed your budget.
Okay, so.
Well, that's one, right?
Yeah. Okay.
I don't know if there's another copy of this.
Did this one get submitted?
Yeah.
Did someone get submitted to the select board?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
They have any questions about it?
They, when I.
Didn't go over it.
Oh, they haven't even gone over, nothing to that one, okay.
No.
Got it. And when you put in the contingency, what exactly was that for? Just for overage?
Emergency, yeah.
Emergency?
Yeah, I forgot what it was. Oh, yeah, 1900 for contingency.
Where was that one, Jody, on the?
Camp Raleigh. I put that just because, I just added.
Do you have any more of those?
Printed off a bunch. Did they get stopped somewhere? I printed off 10 copies. Kathy has.
Kathy has the whole pile.
Yes.
Is that the one?
No.
Look like it?
No, it's yours.
That's the 35K.
Oh.
That's not it.
No, that's not it.
It's a small one, oh wait, did you?
I don't have enough one.
I gave you the small one.
I have to get one.
So, we have this, so it, I sent it to you guys in one of the last emails, I said, it should have been attached there, if you have that on your phone or.
Okay, and so, on the drive to. Yeah, it's for 42,000, and.
And that's different than this one.
Yeah, 'cause she added in a contingency after, after this was received.
So, that's different.
Bus fees of 3,000.
Okay. So that's.
These are two different things right here.
So that's different.
So, well, you have the one, yeah, that Jody's doing.
Yep, emergency, that's for them.
Okay. So the, so, and I, the only issue that I was concerned about looking at this, was the pay salary of the director and assistant director, 'cause we had talked about raising that.
Okay.
So there's a significant change in the 8158, if you look at, if we go that route, now I don't, weren't here that day, I don't think, but we had talked about a $19, an hour for our director, our new director, and $16 an hour for our assistant director.
What did we pay them last time?
$13.25 and $10.75.
You said.
So we said up to $19 for the director and up to $16 for the assistant?
Yes, that was a conversation that we all had, right?
Yes.
Couple weeks ago, right?
Sounds familiar.
Yeah. So I ran those numbers, so for 320 hours, the director would then be at $6,080, and the assistant director, and that would be at the top, that would be at that 19 and 16, would be 5120. So we're talking 11.2 for,
So the director is up to how much?
$6,080.
For the summer?
Yes.
And how much for the?
The assistant director would be 5120.
Okay. Can you send that new spreadsheet, with those numbers? And then you're also gonna have to increase your tuition line, to offset it.
Right.
So put it in tuition.
And we had sort of talked about that. So this is mine, I'm off here though, you have that up there.
Our bus fees were what last year, were three?
See, our bus fees got skewed because we had that week where.
Yeah, you had the water main break and you had the week that you had to get a break from Haven.
Yeah.
So that's why I put the contingency line in, because the buses were really bothering us. Oh, and I also put in first aid. First aid training, because we have.
Yeah, so I think for the sake of the numbers, we'll change and to get it looked at, we'll change the salaries.
Yeah.
Because the other thing. We'll increase the tuition to somehow narrow it.
Yeah.
We'll put in a fake, I shouldn't say fake.
A number.
Yeah.
And then we'll work it out.
A number, then we'll work it out.
Backwards.
Yeah.
As we.
Because the other thing we had talked about too was the counselors making $9 an hour. But I didn't know how many of these, how many counselors this was here, Dee, do you remember? What our number was, how many was that?
And I can't find my.
I think I have 11 total, but two of them are part of.
So I did this.
Yeah, it was nine and two.
So if you do, that math, so that goes up, that number goes up too. So that's,
How much was the counselor's getting before?
We had a pretty wide scale from seven.
To 11.
50, 750 was the bottom line to, none of our counselors made 11. 850 was, I think, our highest paid counselor.
And that felt bad.
Yes. So we had talked about a $9 average, I believe, for counselors across the board. Now, I still think a 60-year-old counselor, first timer, should not be making that. So I think we can.
But they're gonna go to uniform and make 12.
At 16?
Back in groceries.
What? That was 10. I talked to Sam.
My son just got married at Regal for $9 an hour.
Where did he go?
Regal.
Was there a reason why we felt we should increase the director and assistant director's salaries so significantly?
Yes.
To get a director and assistant director. We were told by other committee members throughout last spring that they had people in mind who would apply, but weren't applying because they couldn't afford their, that wage in the summer.
And we, but we did have a director and assistant director, but we determined that overall we got what we paid for?
Yes, and that we would like a bigger pool in the future. And so if we raise the rates, then we may be able to get a bigger pool to choose applicants from.
And just for my clarification, so our agreement for employment, or the town's agreement for employment for those people has ended? So they're not, they don't have any advantage by having worked here before and they can apply again?
Correct.
Got it.
It'll be 20 per counselor. So if we had nine counselors, then it'd be 22,680. So if we have nine counselors at $9 an hour, comes to 22,680. Because it would be 35 hours a week per counselor. So it still allows us part-time people that if we don't need to do all full-time.
So you're changing the 19 to what?
It's 22, what did I just say?
22,680?
Yeah. Nine times 280. So we basically come to 25,20 a counselor. So if we hired nine, it's 22,680.
Can you work the amount of work per counselor?
25,20. But, you know, again, that's for the whole summer. And we really, if you look at the hours worked for every counselor last year, there was very few that came close to the 280 hours.
Yes.
So.
Time off, not early, came in late.
Right.
Yep.
Right. So that would be our, you know, max.
Yep.
I talked to Kate White, she's the Dover rep. director.
Mm-hmm.
And she would come and talk to us and share whatever, you know, if we wanted to pick her brain of what, how they run it.
Which program does she run?
On the rec.
Which school? Is it a school one?
The
now?
Dover rec.
Oh, she is Camp?
Yeah. Because
I talked to that guy before. I talked to the other guy. So I don't know. She must be the director then.
Yeah, she's
okay.
The director. And she's very easy to talk to. And she said she'd come to a meeting and let us pick her brain.
Because they do... that was one of the people I talked to last year, was the, I can't remember his name for the life of me, but he's like he's probably her boss.
Okay.
So he was the one that Ray, I think his name was. That's how I got all their information,
mm-hmm.
when I went and talked to him.
Mm-hmm.
So they go to the pool every afternoon. I mean, that's one of the things that they do. It's kind of nice for there. They just walk across, you know, walk next door. It's kind of nice. They don't worry about buses or anything.
Mm-hmm.
So you're raising. So you need to put in a number here.
Did you raise the grant amount too?
Yes. Jody and I talked about that. Because there are three grants. The day
okay.
we talked about the team camp, there are. Three or four grants that we can go after if we come up with a mission statement in the next couple months. One for TD Bank, not for TD Bank, for Eastern Bank for $5,000. There's one for Dick's that we can ask for money and or sponsorship equipment. And then there is one for, there's one for the Strawberry Fest, but that would come in last minute. And then I pulled this off my computer. The donations we brought in this year are $2,810. And that was below the amount that we took in below the amount that I think was there. And we had $225 in gift card donations. So if you add that up, that's over $3,000 of cash and gift card donations that we got. So Jody and I bumped it up, thinking maybe if we can go after some of these grants from these other organizations, and we can put it in there. But I'm wondering, do we want to leave it all in Summer Rec, or do we want to pull it out and put it in a separate, can we pull it out and put it in a separate line item? So it can go to any rec program and we can distribute it how we want, or do we leave it in Summer Rec and all the money we get goes to Summer Rec? Oh, we had the REF one, which was $600.
I thought we had that option, Jody, don't we?
Rec is rec.
Rec is rec.
Okay.
That's what I thought.
So it doesn't matter where it is. So yes, we, between what we brought in gift cards and donations this year, it was over three.
Yeah. Everything that you're presenting, first off, gotta clean up the numbers with $42,000 if we're gonna raise the salary. But everything we're presenting is revenue neutral except for Family Fund Day, that is town allocated funds going to an organization, and the senior program, which would be town allocated funds going towards that program. Everything else was revenue neutral. How are you raising funds for basketball? Let's finish this
first, and then I'll ask you that question.
So if you look at the numbers that we just did, the total director and assistant director would be $11,200, and then the counselor hourly rate would be $22,680. Makes
so
sense to you?
$33,880
yeah. would be the total on salaries.
So, just for giggles, if we divide that by a tuition of $240, that's 141 kids.
was the total amount for staff?
33,880.
Does that include part-time staff too? Or just?
I think we just did 9 full-time, so I think we counted like. That 91 was primarily, because right now it's a $42,000, so nothing much going to change. And I can't do all that math in my head. And we can do it ourselves.
Jean out.
You talk so much yourselves, I gotta find it.
Are we fine with these numbers? While she's ready to see.
Put it in.
Because it would raise it to $42,000, or $45,000. Right?
And last year we put in the $39,000.
But we didn't use it all. We didn't raise it all. When I did reach out to Kate at one of the school board meetings, and I told her that we would need to know ASAP that they, we have a classroom, because they can't work without a classroom. It's just not going to fly. There's no AC. There's no shade. There's no, the kids must have been so hot. Jordan must have been exhausted. I just felt so bad for them.
And what happens if we don't get a classroom?
Personally, I don't think we surely can. I can't imagine no shade. It was.
Or we just try to do a little easy up, do a little easy up city or something, you know, on the field.
I'm also thinking about those portable air conditioners. Just plug in and they should have a cold day.
Yeah, outside though?
Yeah, where would you put it? Outside.
Put it in gym.
Yeah, they didn't even have like full use of the gym. We were supposed to have the stage, we were supposed to have the gym. We didn't get that. Not all year. They kept having to move anything around. So they had a smart board in the middle of the gym while they were trying to play basketball. And they surrounded the smart board with like chairs so no one could go near it. But I'm like, they don't even have full use of the gym today. It was a hot day. The council's worked really good to work around all the remodeling of the school.
So well, are they planning any big remodels next year?
We won't know until their school budget tells us.
Right, but she also told us that they weren't, though.
Well, I mean,
she also told us that they weren't, though.
Repairs. But there was also an issue with windows one day, like they were doing the windows in the kindergarten along the wall, and they had to keep the kids.
But hopefully
the
back of the school is.
Oh, Judy just mentioned the CIP.
Well,
CIP
for a while.
I was just at the CIP. She mentioned a bunch of stuff. I don't remember.
What's the CIP?
Was that a meeting you weren't at? That was a meeting I wanted to know that.
Oh my goodness.
Can we put in online or you know, put some money in for buying some easy ups to when you go home?
Yeah, we can.
At least if we had, you know, 4 or 5 of those and they set them up every single day together, at least we had some shade.
Okay. And there's video cameras out back, so we can put some up and they really won't be touched as long as we like put a little sign like, smile, you're on camera. So I like the one that you had, that you let Jason borrow, that extra long one.
Yeah.
Those are great.
I think we got a couple of those.
Yeah.
I think it was like $100.
Oh wow, that's great. She had one that was extra long, not the regular basic one.
Yeah, right.
Really liked it.
Because we could set up a nice spot, like, you know, where the shed is, the you know, the ball and the garden, and we could take a little city out, you know, even in like the outfield or you know, the softball field. Or,
yeah.
there any potential contingent location if they are doing a bunch of remodels?
Town hall.
The plumbing burst, you know, whatever, I mean, yeah, I understand what you're saying. And yes, she came home numerous days and was like, oh my God.
My kids
just
hurt them.
Laid in front of the AC. What other options do we have?
We don't have another swamp in town. Can't let it play at the transfer station.
American Legion.
Yeah. That, and then you got the baseball field across the street, and you got...
They don't allow just anyone on that field, though.
Well, but I'm saying, no, we can...
Exactly.
We can speak
no,
to
yeah,
them,
yeah.
And...
Just saying.
Charge.
I mean... actually,
oh, yeah.
The bus just killed us when we had to take off and
go,
so maybe we can speak to them about, you know, if the school's like, well, we might be doing construction, or even just to be like, hey, this happened last year, if we have something like this happen where the pipes burst or whatever, and we need a week, is this something that we could do?
Who's got connections there?
I don't.
I've been talking to Joe, I wonder. I think Joe's still a...
Joe Kramer.
We forgot what they call it.
The Legion of Mess.
Yeah. And we're just, right now, saying, hey, if something happened and we needed a week.
Right.
And then we might have to go back to him if Kate says, no, we're gutting the whole school this summer.
And then
we
go back to insurance.
Insurance.
And we get a copy of their insurance, just like we do for Family Fun Day. We have to have insurance on that. So in case somebody gets hurt.
So we would just have...
It's just a piece of paper. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Unless they bring insurance after all those fireworks they set off.
It wasn't the fireworks. It was somebody getting hurt that spawned. That
really?
We need insurance coverage,
huh.
Kind of thing.
The other thing is that you might talk to the mill ownership and see, I don't know, if he has open space. He has offered before when I talked to the gentleman that manages the mill to allow me to use the room off of the library at no charge as a community space for senior program, but I'm not sure it's appropriate for children.
I mean, in the library, though? That room in the back in the library?
Yeah.
Right. We'd have to out the librarians, too. I mean, it's not, I mean, it's a decent sized space, but not for, like, a whole camp.
Yeah, no.
But the other thing is that,
you know,
thinking
the
parking
lot in North Country Hearts,
if they have, like, they're, I don't know what it looks like inside, but they used to have a church that had a huge space on one of the upper floors.
Fourth.
And that needs to be open and stuff. I don't know if it's still there.
I don't know if that would be an issue with church and state.
No, the church isn't there anymore.
Okay, so we're not going to be.
It used to be.
It used to be. Yeah, no. It's an empty space now.
I'm thinking,
I
have an issue.
I think somebody rented it already. I think it's rented already. But there might be, like, I think on the first floor there was kind of a big space down there, too. I don't know. But yeah, you're saying, are you bringing 50?
Well, if we have a week this next coming year, we know we need to come up with some better options.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, I asked her as soon as she knew. So hopefully it's like January.
Oh, they've had a classroom before, so it's not beyond the...
They've always had.
They used
right.
to,
yeah. But the last 2 years
right.
they were doing renovations.
Right.
Number for the budget that we want for summer.
your payroll taxes are gonna change, right?
Yeah.
Can you put that together?
Yeah, I told Jody I'd get it to her tomorrow morning.
Okay.
I'll send it out to everybody tomorrow morning.
Okay.
So this was the listing I did for pizza, and what it was for the different, six different places I went, six or seven places, and, I had a discussion with somebody not too long ago that, at our last meeting, we talked about how it took a very long time for whoever went to get the pizza to come back. Sometimes they would be gone for long periods of time during the middle of the day, and they would, pizza would arrive late or something. So it was suggested, usually the director or the assistant director, mostly the director from what I understand. So it was suggested that maybe we talk to people that just deliver, and then nobody's having to leave the grounds, so.
It was never really an issue until this year.
It may have just been whoever was in that position.
Lack of knowledge of the area and being lost, got it.
Yes, because I know I suggested that we use Supa's Pizza out of Dover a couple times, and there was lack of knowledge of the higher ups. They did not know where that was, and they probably would have given us the best deal. So I've broken it down to how much it cost, how much it would be for five cheese and five pepperoni, the total, and how much we would make per pizza. And I've marked up the ones I know I have delivery for. So I don't know if Little Caesar delivers or not. So.
Yeah, I know they
don't. So
Caesar's a lot.
I guess before we do that, and maybe this has been addressed because I have not been able to make the last two meetings, I know the town wants us to stop doing the using petty cash and just submitting receipts process. So we would have to figure out the process that we would want to use and then the pizza place that would best work with that, i.e., you know, buying gift cards or something, pre-buying at the beginning of the year all of our pizzas and getting that approved by the town. So we can get a check, pay for it.
Oh, I agree.
My
question was.
Yes. And then if we went to them and said, we're going to order two pizzas from you every Wednesday for 8 weeks, we're going to pay ahead of time. How much is it? Take it to the town, get it approved, get the check, give it to them.
Would it be like a purchase order? Would that be like a purchase order item, or is that just too small of an amount?
If you do it in bulk, you could, but.
I mean, the way
that's something that I don't understand why. Like, I'm like, it's been in existence for 30 years. Why now? And the answer was, the auditor has always said something. I'm like, okay.
so if you want to go down,
it would be simple for it. Just would be simple for the whole program. We just did it that way, wouldn't it? I mean,
right. Yeah.
You know, like,
just 2 o'clock on Wednesday, they arrive with two large pizzas or whatever.
And we can have a check pre-cut for them.
I think the more that we can take away, I think we're moving in this direction.
Yeah.
We can take away the counselors handling cash and doing that, get rid of that altogether if we can.
Oh, I think that was the fun part, you know.
Because that was probably, it seemed to me, when I was dropping my kids off, and I was like, hey, biggest frustrations for all of the whole camp last year was that.
We'd like to get everything online, is what we'd like to do. So if you go, if you go with one pizza place, your two top choices would be Supa's Pizza, and they have a flat rate for any school or local town group. Nonprofit group would be $8 per pizza for an 18-inch pizza, and you could make charging $1 a slice. You would make back your money if you sold them as 8 slices. They will cut the slices smaller into 12 slices if you want, or if you raise the price, like for pepperoni, you would make
Look, it gets so confusing. I personally would just vote for either X-naying the pizza altogether or just making it, instead of charging $2.40 for the camp, we're going to charge $2.50, and on Wednesdays, every kid gets 2 slices of cheese pizza.
All inclusive.
Okay.
Like the buses.
Yeah, I mean.
You know, all inclusive, I think, would make a lot of people happy.
Yeah, we never did pizza because I was like, I'm just making your lunch and
yeah.
Just sending you.
Yeah. And you know what? If,
it was just easier.
It just would make everyone's life easier. We would know exactly how many pizzas we'd need. And if not that many kids showed up, it's already paid for, so. Okay.
So send it home to the Andersons.
And it might actually benefit because there were kids that would show up and they would pay. They didn't necessarily tell the counselors the first couple weeks,
right.
But I know they told their parents, and then their parents would say, well, my child didn't get pizza today, and it was like, oh, well, we'll get them pizza next week. Well, next week's the 4th of July, and we're out of town, so we'll get them the pizza the week after. And it's just like, and then it just got lost in the shuffle because then the kid wasn't there, and they never got their pizza, and the parents had to pay for it.
So the only thing then, so yeah, it. I think that's a great option. Either don't have it.
Or don't do it. I mean, how many of the kids make or break the pizza? Because we don't really make that much money off of it for the headache that it is. And how many kids are like, oh, I gotta go to camp so I can get pizza?
Yeah. So. I think I remember my son wanting lunch from home rather than the pizza.
But the other comment I heard from another parent was they didn't want their kid getting Little Caesars pizza. They wanted better quality pizza. Why
so
pay?
So it sounds like it's taking more people off.
Yeah, right.
And it's
that's
a pain in the rear for the counselors. It's the pain in the rear for the guy that's trying to figure out the money. So what is the plus here? We make 17 cents maybe if we can sell enough pizza, or we might lose money that week because.
Or maybe we
did put it in a freeze box.
Yeah. Or maybe we do it like the last week as like a special thing, or you know what I mean? Like just make it a special.
I'm a fan of that.
Or you get there and you don't have cash.
Orders.
And you don't have
yeah. I think we paid in pennies one day in the car.
So.
I'm wondering how we kept getting more pennies.
So do we want to make a motion then?
Do we need to make a motion to eliminate?
No,
it's
that would go under supplies and function of the thing itself. But you do need to make a motion of what your bottom line number is for spending and income and expenses. So right now it's at 42.4, but we haven't put in the things, the correct numbers yet. So if we're not going to meet before tomorrow, and you'll have those numbers tomorrow, do you want to make a motion up to 47,000? And what? Because I'm assuming you won't go over that.
Heck, we could just make it even 100,000 if you won't go over that.
We won't stress out the budget committee because
we
just went
up 4,000 alone.
So we don't have, what we don't have is payroll taxes.
So 46.4. So
11.2. So wait,
I would say, did you say 47? Because I would say that. Maybe 49?
So it's 3,042 with just the director alone. So it's a plus 3,000. And then, right? 22. 680. About 59, some $6,000.
Does that include taxes and?
That does not include like payroll taxes. So.
So do we want to go 50?
So up to 50,000. And then you'll send a vote.
Yeah. Okay.
As long as I have it by six.
We have to second that?
Yeah, so if, to talk about it, you don't have to okay it.
Yes, I'll second it.
Thank you.
Now we're into discussion about it, so Jody made a motion to raise.
Bottom line.
Bottom line.
Bottom line.
That should cover.
Up to $50,000. And no more, right?
That's gonna change.
Motion line's gonna have to change in your counselor line's gonna have to change in your payroll tax line, it's gonna change.
Yep. Training and orientation, it's gonna have to change.
Well.
It'll change because now we're, their salary's bigger.
Oh, good eye.
How many hours was that, do we know?
I think it was a day, it was a day.
Well.
I'm sorry, I'm lost.
See, we have three.
I thought it was two or three days.
Might have been two, cause I think it was the, oh.
Okay, so. Well, I will do my best to.
Jody did hers 3 days.
Best I can.
For four staff.
3 days?
Yeah. Are you, was Camp Raleigh the same thing, 3 days?
Well, I think, remember how we did it last year was, we included, it actually was 1 day.
It was 1 day.
One day, because we included July 3rd and July 4th as, training days, but we, that was in the summer payroll. So it was only one extra day, that's how that worked out.
So she had, so Kathy had the last year, $590.
Well, everything was increased by 3%.
3%, right.
So that's why this is different.
Yeah.
Yeah, this was last year.
Yeah, so that was just 1 day for those
Yeah.
two, so, but it actually includes 3 days of training.
July 4th this year would be Wednesday.
Yeah, right, so we talked about the calendar a little bit last year that, or last week maybe, that because July 4th falls in the middle of the week, that we would probably just have that 1 day off. Instead of going Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday off, or Wednesday, Thursday, Friday off.
Yeah.
What do you guys, what, just the Wednesday, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Now,
So then that actually might need to be, that might need to be doubled. Because last year we used those 2 days in July as training, so now if we need 3 days of training, we're gonna have to compensate for that second day.
Alright.
Now, is, for Camp Raleigh, is it 1 cent fee for the summer still, or did we decide on sessions, or?
We haven't even decided that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Or pay by the week?
It's a whole other level.
You still haven't voted on your $50,000.
Alright.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any nays?
No nays.
Okay, now you can ask your question.
I think it was our nays. I'll just put it behind the vote.
Alright.
Budget's just getting bigger and bigger.
Yeah.
We're all gonna double it. But, yeah. It's the job market, it's crazy. It's a good thing for everybody, but not when you're coming, not when you're talking about your taxes and things like that.
Lester's tired.
Are we open for any business now, or?
Sure.
So I sent you a note, but I'm gonna be stepping away from the committee, so I just wanted to let you guys know that.
You did, I didn't see it.
Yeah, I responded when you sent out a note about this, I did reply.
Sorry.
It was actually about midnight.
I I usually wait for my
Do you reply
to
all
or
just
to
D?
I'm sorry.
It might have been just you, like 3, 4 days ago, something like that.
Sorry, I didn't see it.
That's okay.
I'm not gonna joke for it.
I'm coaching at the high school now and running another basketball team and just once in a while seeing the family. You can sympathize with that, and I couldn't get in the last two meetings. And my wife said, "Well, you're not going to meetings. You suck as a member." And I'm like, "You're right."
So, thank you for all your help.
Well, and I think everyone's done a great job, and I think that next year will be even better, especially if we do the inclusive and, like you said, all the less money exchanging, the better.
Mm-hmm.
It might scare some people that it's 260 or whatever we come up with,
right,
instead of 240, but
you don't have the little
all the nickel and diming every week
is
gone, or you know.
Yeah.
So then I think the team thing's great as well. I like I've mentioned to you, I do have some jerseys, some shorts, and some basketballs.
I should come get those from you at some point.
Yeah, or you can still keep the basketballs. And I can give you the shirts. No. So just let me know,
yeah,
and I can get that. Year,
okay.
Or whatever the case might be. So,
and I'm trying to think if I could swing by at some point. Then.
So, do we need to talk basketball? No, that's okay. Jordy mentioned earlier, how are we raising money for basketball?
Well, right now we don't need any money for basketball. So, so we're having two open gyms Tuesday and Friday, and to see how many kids there are that want to participate, and I forgot.
Did it start last week already, or is this the first week?
Last week.
Do you have any idea what the turnout was?
Yeah, so it's been pretty low. We actually have more kids on, what day is it today? So Friday. So we did it Tuesday and Friday, and I think we had about 10 third and fourth graders, and then we had very low numbers for the 5-6. There was six there on Friday. We had two kids from out of town who came, so from South Berwick. So we could actually, it was a pretty good turnout. So what we've been trying to figure out is how many kids we actually would have to field the team. And right now, it looks like the only team that would be there is third and fourth grade boys. I think we've had the most. I think we had 8 third and fourth grade boys that have shown up. But yeah, everybody else is lacking numbers. We had 2 third grade girls. Yours was the third, so we actually had 3.
That's on play for Tri-City.
Right. And then we had, you know, 2 fifth, sixth grade girls, and 2 fifth, sixth grade boys from Rollinsford, and then 2 others from out of town. So that's kind of how it played out on Friday. So.
So if you only have the boys' team, you have to pay for refs, right?
Right.
And
that would
that
only
start?
Be for home games.
Okay. When would that
And be? That usually would be after January 1st.
Okay, so it would be next budget.
And I don't know, we've had some people, and you might have to tell me, well, that's the thing, too. Some people have volunteered. So
Paula's third.
I know, Paula's awesome.
Yeah, Paula's like either 30 or 35 bucks
a game. Right?
So if you just have one team, you're looking at, you know, call it $35.
Right.
That's court system. She doesn't find by herself.
Right, right. We don't need two. But we've had some parents who are like, I don't know if they're, we were kind of talking about if they were official, but you know, do we need officials for third, fourth grade boys? I don't know.
That's up to your league.
Yeah.
Everyone has one official that isn't a parent.
Yeah.
I think you gotta.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, it if you have 6 home games, let's say they play a total of 12 games. That's what? 6 times 35, whatever that is, call it $200.
need $400 though.
Right.
So how much is, how are we paying the reps?
How they used to do it was they had, and again, town would hate this, okay, but how they do it is they have the snack bar where they sell candy, hot dogs,
drinks,
whatever,
pickles.
And then at the end, they went into the drawer and they got her $35 and they went, here you go. Now that Caroline would not enjoy that.
Yeah.
But that's.
Well, if we keep receipts are what she wants. So.
But she doesn't want us to
pay with cash.
Pay with cash and then give her receipts. Mm-hmm. Not what she wants. What she wants is ahead of time, which we could do.
Yeah.
I mean,
you could definitely
it's,
do.
Hey, we're
you
gonna
know
have
the schedule ahead of time.
Yeah.
So that this shouldn't be a big of a problem with some of the.
I mean, you'd have to have a line item on the budget or whatever.
But you don't know who the rep is going to be.
Well, you schedule that. Now, there are times when, you know, hey, ref A can't make it, and you have to find someone else, so you have ref B. But.
They're generally, oh, yeah, I guess they're cutting
not
people a check.
Yep. But it's usually not that day. Like, how far in advance would you need to know if, oh, Jim, the ref Jim, can't make it, so we got the ref Sally to come.
Checks are coming Monday.
So she would need to know a week ahead of time. Most of the time, that's not an issue.
Okay.
But there definitely are times where...
calls in
it's the most expensive you've ever seen a ref.
Well, we use, most of them will do it for like $30 or $35. I mean, yeah, you can pay $50.
Baseball's $35.
So, I mean, worst case scenario, they usually know us and, hey, we're going to get the check cut for you on Monday. It'll be at the town hall or we can mail it to you. I don't think most of them, I mean, half the time they're coming back the following weekend to do another game and I just hold it and give you the next.
Okay.
So, most of them.
Okay. And we still have, because I don't want you to lose reps either in the process.
Yeah.
There are still two cases of water at the school, and I have one that I need to get back over to the school that belong to rec at basketball community.
So, do you need any help for basketball, or are you good?
There's been like 4 or 5 volunteer coaches that have come in.
Okay.
So,
Ryan Gadden already said that he looks like he's going to be the boys.
I'm like, good for you.
Yeah.
Already went out there.
And
his little boy plays.
Honestly, I think it's going to start back at 3rd and 4th.
Yeah.
And then they're going to be the 5th and 6th.
Right.
Because all the other kids that are already at Marshwood or Dover or wherever are there.
Right.
So they're not going to come out.
Do you still have the uniforms from years past?
Well, that's what I was saying. I have some
in
my house.
I don't know if, does Kelly still have some at her house or did you?
Loudon was the one that
Loudon
had most everything.
Okay.
And I just have some because I borrowed some, so I don't even have a full team. I got like 4 or something. When we did the 3-on-3 thing.
Yeah.
And I still have them from that. So.
Yeah, so that's the, and so I don't know if the last year that we, 2 years ago that when we had the teams, that we did charge kids, I think would we charge 20 or 25 that year? So, you know, if that's what we're going to do to fund the refs, then is that something that $25 to play? Does that need to be voted on? Yes. So am I making a motion? What do you think? Is that what we charge?
I think you're trying to get the program back going. Personally, I would not
charge.
Just to get it back going. That's my thought.
Did we need a second before we jumped into the discussion?
That's my thought, is you're just getting it going again. It's $400. Can rec, I mean, that's what I'm, and if you didn't do.
We might not even do Frosty.
If you didn't
right?
do Frosty,
didn't do
then you're looking at, and they're 3rd and 4th graders.
Right.
So you're looking at $200 then.
Right.
Can you raise $200? From donations and selling water and you know, well, hell, I'll donate $50, okay? You know, I mean, I do that versus charging.
You would normally have an out-of-town fee and an in-town fee like Sunshine does.
Right.
So, but as long as you make it aware that everybody can join, that's my only concern.
And I think you can hold off until to find out how many kids you have show up. I mean, if you just, you know, send out the emails through the town and have the open gyms and then tell the kids from the open gyms.
Well, that's what the open gyms are free.
Yeah.
Right, so that's where we're kind of getting interest for that.
I mean, the only.
I don't have a problem with charging. I think wherever, even we made it $20, right? If you're asking kids to pay $20, because what, I mean, I know I just signed up Tia at Marshwood for, it was 75 for her to play over there for 5th and 6th, and I think.
Yeah, but they go on like 90 tournaments.
Is this the rec travel?
No, that's the rec, Lester. So
oh, that's not even Bears
team? That's not even Bears team.
Oh, boy.
That's the rec program. So I think we had to pay another fee on top of that if you were invited to the travel team. I think it was another, maybe another $50 per kid or something like that. Yeah. Invited. So yeah, they're charging $75 for a rec program, and I think the boys, honestly, I think the boys' rec Marshwood is even more expensive than the girls because they're two separate entities. I think they're like, I think somebody told me it was $85 for the boys' rec. So I mean, I think you charge our kids $20 and out of town kids $30.
And I got a flyer from a friend, Elliot, and they are charging, I think, $30 for open gyms. If you're an Elliott resident, $40 if you're an outside resident.
Just for open gym.
And they started yesterday. And they go through December, with the exception of the week of Thanksgiving and the week of.
Is it once a week or twice a week? Or what?
Once a week. But it's these are pre-K through third. And then they also have. Starting in January, and I think it's...
That's probably a team thing, right? In January. That's when everybody starts their team.
And I think that is up in that range, too. $75 to $80 is the out-of-town.
I mean, if you charge $20, you got your, you know, assuming you do 6 home games.
Right. It's almost there.
Then you... you're good. You can make $10 off of selling water.
Yeah. Right.
Even if you charge 10 for town, in town, $20.
Are we going to allow out of town?
Of course, we're not a rec program. We're not a school program anymore.
Well, I understand that, but
yeah.
You have to allow, does the rec have to allow people from out of town?
You can.
That's somewhere in our Rollinsford bylaws or something?
No.
What about if you get some sort of a league or their regulations on, you know, drawing kids from
not really at that age. Yeah, they just.
Yeah, they're just kind
of learning.
Yeah. So what do we need to do?
I know what I need to do.
20
For Jody.
Okay.
Oh, and for you. 20, right?
I don't know. 20? We want to go 20 Rollins for kids and 25 out of town kids.
$30 out of town kids. Who's gonna not pay $20 to kids who wants to spend out of town?
Right.
I mean, you know,
so
that's why we're gonna make our lives very easy. So yeah. You know, we can already fund the program and get the reps.
And that's only for the kids who we have enough kids for a travel team.
The open gyms are free.
Open gyms are free.
Great.
Yep. Does that sound good?
Mm-hmm. Question about
what?
If a family comes in and says we can't afford it, are we waiving the fee?
No.
Sorry.
I vote that we waive the fee.
I will so miss you, Leslie.
Well, he just volunteered to pay it for one or two of us.
Yeah, that was assuming we weren't charging any kids. Now she wants to charge the kids and take my donation.
Hey, well, 40 of that's coming for me, actually, for my twins. So.
Oh, yeah.
That's half the team right there.
Paying for one game herself.
I'm covering one rep.
You still didn't vote on it.
Okay, well, we had two numbers out there. So should... And so I don't know how to put that. 20, do we want 20 for Rollinsford and 25 for out of town, if we have any of those, or 20 for Rollinsford and 30 for out of town? Can I present it that way?
I make a motion to make basketball program registration fee $20 for residents, $30 for non-residents for the program of 2018.
I'll second that. Got you, Dan.
Okay, so motion made by Jody to charge $20 for travel basketball in town and $30 for out of town non-residents for 2018 season, right?
Yeah. And right now we only have all in town kids for the third, fourth graders that have shown up. So.
That's great. There's like eight.
Yeah, there's like eight kids. It's perfect. Yeah.
So right now,
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Nays?
I'm
So do they know that they're there for a week, or just open gym right now?
Just open gym.
Did you abstain, or you're just saying one abstain?
I don't know.
He abstained.
I'm just one.
But I was asking Kelly.
She voted for it.
No, I voted.
Okay.
I voted to put my $40 in.
Do you end up table the ice rink? Or?
No one's.
I promised I'd be home by now.
That's okay. Well,
5 minutes.
I know.
No one's heard about the ice rink, so no one wants to heads it. So.
Do you, Kathy?
I know nothing about ice. So.
I have no desire to do ice either. So.
Ice is not my thing.
What does it entail? I'm just asking. Probably not going to go in.
Put
up the boards.
Put up the boards. No one to ask the fire department to water it. No one to keep people off of it. Shovel it every storm.
Dan.
So.
I got enough
ice.
My son's travel hockey. I got enough ice in my life.
Everyone have a good evening.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, Lester. Good luck. I'll keep track of you guys on Facebook and all the rest of that.
We're not going to allow anyone to
email you.
See you later.
Bye, Lester.
I mean, the amount of time that the rink was open, last year and before, it was open for a week. The weather it's going to be 7 degrees on Monday, and God knows what we're going to have in store this winter, so who knows if we're going to have the weather for it.
But
it changed.
I don't know when to not allow somebody on the ice. Like, it looks all in the video.
Right.
Sure. Like, I don't know those rules.
And I'm going there. I'm ignorant.
Like, I'm more than happy to shovel, but I've been out there shoveling
it. It's so hard to enforce. It's just there. I mean, it's, like, there was a big sign about, you can't have a hockey stick on the ice. And it's like, well, nobody's here. He's passing the puck with a kid. It's a big deal.
Was there a lot of use last year? I mean, historically, the last 5 years, I should say?
I don't think a lot. You could say that. Yeah. There were some, we brought the kids over a couple times. And
you're lucky. One of the only days that it was open, I was like, I didn't know.
Right. So. They had one event where they had like a little bonfire and people went in. It was great, and then try to. I think it's a great idea to have a rink in town, but it's just.
responsible for all of that stuff?
The, all we have right now is the tarp, right?
In the morning, I think. I don't know if the wood's still there.
I'll have to go check. I know the tarp's at the fire station.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it was donated, so we can either donate it back or just hope that somebody else takes it and comes along that is interested.
Well, maybe we can table that up and talk about it again next week.
Mm-hmm. Oh, speaking of, can you like to put something out there that we need a person to spearhead?
Looking for someone who's interested in here. Because I might email them, see out there in the community.
Yeah. Facebook page?
Oh, into that idea.
So with the budget sort of gone, what do we do?
Our next meeting.
How?
I think we're going to have the luxury of having another month, but I think as we start figuring out the new programs, we really need to meet more frequently than that. That's my opinion.
So December 6th, you're presenting to the budget committee.
Yeah.
So that's a Wednesday night. What time? What, do you know what time that is?
6:30.
Okay.
Is that first come, first serve?
What?
Budget committee presentation.
As listed. As listed.
As listed.
The 6th of December?
Yeah. Yes. So that would be here in the, it would probably be in D.
Is it printed
yet?
Yeah.
Is it printed
last time? I can't meet on December 3rd.
You bully your way
Sunday
to the table and start presenting. Nobody's going to care.
Yeah.
December 3rd, I can't meet.
Okay.
I won't be here, but the 10th, I can meet. It's a Sunday. We want to do 10?
Sure.
Yeah. And what's the date?
December.
Sunday,
yeah.
12:10, 7 o'clock again?
Yeah.
Do we want to inquire about, we just lost one, we haven't seen a couple.
I know exactly what you're saying.
Do we want to invite others interested in being on the rec committee to attend that meeting?
Sure.
Yep.
Sure.
Say, can you send out, resend out a list of who is actually a member and an alternate.
And I will update it and send it out with a test. I think it's big.
And we might want to
need attendance.
So are we thinking that the people who have been here more frequently need to go to an alternate?
I think they are, but I just want to be sure. I know it's on the drive somewhere.
Can I just put a plug in Chair's ears that at one of our upcoming meetings we need to discuss a mission statement, get it finalized and voted on so that we can apply for grants?
I thought we did that last year.
We have three of them out there on the
Yeah, because Dan, you started that, right?
I thought Dan
discuss that at the next meeting.
Okay. Agenda.
Yep.
Dan, you find that and send it to us.
I might not yet, I might not, yes, somewhere.
I can check too, it was an old.
Yeah, I think you had sent it to me, and I just kind of tweet some things and send it back and shorten it a little.
Yeah, perfect.
Motion approved.
Okay, are we, business is over, can,
Second.
I'm in.
You should change it to I'm in.
I'm in. 9:02. We're all tired. I don't think that's mine.
That's mine.
Really, you have been. Are we?
We've made a motion to adjourn at 9:02.
Yeah.
Fine, good.